गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल सॉल्व एक्सरसाइज 10B, पेज नंबर 181, सम मोर क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम द चैप्टर 10, प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस. सो हियर इज द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन. ए कैलकुलेटर इज सोल्ड फॉर ₹345 एट अ प्रॉफिट ऑफ 15%. फाइंड द कॉस्ट प्राइस ऑफ कैलकुलेटर. At what price must it be sold to earn a profit of 25%? Means suppose if a calculator was sold for ₹345 and he got the profit 15%. So we have to find the cost price. Then after we have to estimate, if I have to find the profit of 25%, then what should be the selling price? So first of all, we find the cost price. So first of all, we will write the data. So what are the given? So given, your SP is given, selling price, which is ₹345. Okay, profit is given. So profit is 15%. It is given. Next, cost price is given. Cost price is not given. So we have to find the cost price. Now, cost price we can find out. So there is a formula also, as I had given in the last when we are solving exercise 10A, there I had given some formula. So directly you can find out, like that formula was like CP equals to SP into 100 divided by 100 plus, there is a profit, so plus 100. If there is a loss, then minus loss percent. So here is the profit, so that's why right here profit percent, okay, in the bracket. This is the formula. So by this formula also you can solve directly, put the value of SP and profit percent, and you will get the cost price. So this is the one method by the help of formula you can solve. Okay, so this is the one method by the help of formula you can solve. You can find the value of cost price. Now I will solve it by the unitary method. Okay, so in the unitary method, how you will solve? So first of all, we will assume it, let if CP is ₹100, then SP will be, selling price will be, what will be selling price? So this 100 plus, so what is the profit or loss? Here is a profit, so we will add 50. So here is 15 plus 15. So altogether it is ₹150. So if the cost price is 100, what is the selling price? 150. So now for the unitary, here you have to see that in the question it is given selling price and we have to find the cost price. So you can see cost price is 100 and the selling price is 115 that we got. So as I told that earlier, when we are solving the unitary method, which part is given? The given part you have to always write in the left side, and which you have to find out, that you should write in the right side. So that's why I will change the sentence, I will switch the sentence, because it will be easy to solve. So the same sentence can I write like this: if selling price equals to 115, then cost price will be ₹100. Yes or no? So that I have changed. Only I changed the sentence, because selling price we have to find out. So that's why I changed the sentence. I just now, can I find for the one? Yes. So for rupees one, sell, if the cost price is one, then the selling price is 1, then cost price will be ₹100 by 150. Now for the 345, so we can find for the ₹345, if the selling price is 345, so cost price will be ₹100 divided by 115, and it will be multiplied by 345. Now we can solve it. So 5 5 to 3 23, and this is also for the 69 time. Okay, now again this 23 we can divide for 3 times, so 3 into 100. So now we got the cost price equals to rupees 100 into 3 300. So what is the answer? 300. So the cost price was 300, but now again we have to sell it. So again, so we will find for the again. So now we got the cost price is rupees 300. Now we have the cost price 300, profit equals to 25%. Okay, now we have to find the selling price. So now we have to find the selling price. Okay, we have to find selling price. So same we will apply. Let if cost price equals to rupees 100, then selling price will be, so profit is there, so of course it will be add, so it will be added to 100. So 100 plus 25, so this is your 125. So this is the selling price if the cost price was 100. So for the one, as a unitary method, first we will find for the one. So if the cost price of is 1, then the SP will be, selling price will be same, we can write 125 by 100. Now for the, now cost price is worth 300, and now here we no need to change the sentence, the sequence. Why? Because already give which one we have to find, selling price, that is already in the right side, no need to change. So now for the 300, so we will find for the 300. So if the cost price is rupees 300, so SP will be rupees 125 divided by 100 and multiply by 300. Okay, now we can cancel this 0, this 20 cancel. Now we can multiply, so selling price will be, you can multiply 125, so you will get rupees 375. So your answer is 375. Okay, so you can see how we have solved. First of all, you can solve by this formula also, otherwise by the unitary method we have to assume the cost price always. We have to assume cost price is 100, not selling price. When we are assuming, always we have to assume the cost price only. Okay, then according to the profit and loss we will subtract in the selling price. So there is a profit, so we will add. So then after, you know, by the unitary method we find the cost price. Again this cost price became, on this cost price we have to find the more profit, so that is 25%. So we find the selling price from here. Okay, so likewise we will solve. So now next question we will solve. So here is question number 2. A fruit seller bought banana at rupees 8.40 per dozen. At what price per 100 he sell them so as to earn profit 15%. Okay, so that we have to find out. So now question number 2 we will solve. So question number 2, so first of all cost price is given, cost price of 1 dozen bananas. So what is the cost price of 1 dozen banana? It is given rupees 8.40. Got it? Now next is that, so we know that in 1 dozen how many banana are there? Total 12 banana. So it will be same. So cost price of 12 banana, it will be rupees 8.40. Okay, up to here it is clear. Now next is, we will find the so cost price of one banana we can get. So for this it will be divided, so rupees 8.40 divided by 12, so this is the cost price of one banana. Now there was total how many banana he sold? 100 banana. So now we will find the cost price of 100 banana. So cost price of 100 banana, so it will be rupees, so we will multiply by 100, 8.40 multiply by 100 and divided by 12. So now we can solve it. So if we remove this decimal, so here will 1, and after decimal how many digits are there? 2. So write 2, so 100 will come here. Now we can divide this 100 cancel. Now this also we can divide how many times? 7 times, so 70. So now, so what is the cost price of 100 banana? 70 rupees. So that is the cost price of 100 banana. So what is the cost price of 100 banana? 70 rupees. Now we will solve. So now we got the cost price. So cost price is your rupees 70. Okay, profit. So profit they should earn 15%. So profit is 15%. Okay, now we have to find the selling price. So what should be the selling price? So that we have to find out. Selling price we have to find out. Now first, then we, now here we write the same type of statement. So if CP equals to rupees 100, then SP will be, selling price will be, so there is a, what is profit? So of course it will be, we will add it. So 100 plus 15, you can solve by the formula also. Directly you can write the formula and you can solve, but here I am solving by the unitary method. So that is rupees 115. Okay, now we will find for the one. If the cost price is rupees 1, so selling price will be rupees 115 by 100. Now for the, so that is rupees, if the cost price is 70, so what will be the selling price? So selling price will be rupees 115 multiply by 70 by 100. Got it? Now we can divide this zero cancel, 2 times, 5 to the 10, here it will be 23, 5 to the 10, 23. Now 23 into 7 we will do here, so 23 into 7 and divided by 2. Okay, so it will be rupees 161 by 2. Okay, so now you can solve, you will get 80.50. okay, so this is your answer. So that is the selling price. Okay, what is the selling price? Rupees 80.50. so here what we have done, first there is given 1 dozen banana cost. So in 1 dozen we know 12 bananas are there, so we find for the one cost of 1 banana, then we find the cost of 100 banana. So after finding 100 banana, this cost price, profit and selling price we have to find out. So now we have we found the selling price by using the unitary method. You can also solve, you can find the selling price by the formula also. So likewise we have solved and we get the solution. Now next question we have, number 3 is the same like Amar purchased a table for 1000 and is spent. So this is cost price and this both you can add, this will be the cost price and there is a profit is there, so you can find the selling price. So this is easy, both you can add, so this will be your cost price and profit is the profit is given 16%, only you have to find the selling price. Okay, now question number 4 I will solve. A man buys eggs at 5 for 6 rupees and sell them 8 for 12 rupees. Find the profit percent. So let's solve. So here question number 4. So question number 4, in this 5x cost is given. Okay, 5x CP is given, cost price. So what is that? Its a cost price is rupees 6. Okay, so 1x will be, x cost price will be, this will be 6/5. Okay, now you can solve, you can divide 6 divided 5, so you will get in point, you will get 1.20. So this is the cost price of 1 egg. Okay, this is the cost price of 1 egg. When he buy means when he buy from the shop 5 for 6 rupees. So at the time he has to pay for 1 egg 1 rupees 20 paise. Now when he sold it, so when he sold, so 8 egg selling price was rupees 12. Okay, here it was 6, and now he sold 8 eggs for 8 egg selling price rupees 12. So for 1 egg selling price equals to, so rupees 12/8. So you can solve it, you will divide this 12 divided 8. So here you will get, this is rupees 1.50. So the selling price of 1 egg is 1 rupees 50 paise, and here is the selling price of, cost price of 1 egg is 1 rupees 20 paise. Got it? So now you can see, this is the cost price and this is the selling price. This is actually selling price 1.50 and this is the cost price 1.20. you can see SP is greater than CP, so it means profit. So here is what type of situation is there, SP is greater than CP. So it means, since SP is greater than CP, so profit equals to SP minus CP. So what is the SP? SP you can see 1.50 and CP 1.20. So that we will solve, 1.50 minus 1.20. So you can subtract, so it will be 0.30, means the profit is rupees 0.30. Okay, now profit we have, now we have to find the profit percent. So we know the formula for the profit percent. So profit percent equals to profit by, always we calculate it from the CP into 100. Now what is the profit? Profit was 0.30 multiplied by 100, and what was the cost price? 1.20. Now you can see this you can remove after 2 digits are here, also 2 digits, so that will cancel. So now this zero cancel, 4 3 4s are 12 4 25 times. So finally we get, what is the percentage, total profit percent was 25%. So this is the answer. Okay, so answer is 25%. So how we have solved? This is the cost price 5x. He bought 5x for rupees 6. So I find the cost of 1 egg, so that is 1 rupees 20 paise. So he sold 8 egg for 12 rupees. So likewise from here also we find the selling price of 1 egg. Now so we can see the selling price is greater than cost price, it means profit. So we got the profit. So now then after we find the profit percent. So our answer is 25%. Okay, now next question we will do. Number 5, yes, question number 5 is same like question number 1. Okay, you can solve question number 5, same it is like number question number 1. Okay, in this question, is there 80 is there, means buys article for 80, cost price is given, profit is there. Then again he sold. So first cost price, profit. Then after again you will the same, you will find the selling price. So that selling price will be cost price for Ramu, for the Ram, and there is a profit. So you can find the selling price. Okay. So same like question number 1, question number 5, you can solve it. Then I will solve question number 6. A shopkeeper bought 1600 eggs at rupees 3.75 per dozen. He sold 900 of them at 2 for 1. Okay, 2 for rupees 1, and the remaining at 5 for 2 rupees. Find the profit and loss. Okay. Now we will solve question number 6. So first it is given one dozen eggs, CP, cost price is given. So what is that? It's a cost price is rupees 3.75. Okay. So rupees 3.75. Now next, in we know in the one dozen how many eggs? So 12 eggs. So of course 12 eggs cost price same. So it will be same rupees 3.75. Okay. Okay. Now next we will find for the one. So one egg cost price will be, so this will be divided by 3.75 divided by 12. Now so but total egg was there 1600 egg he bought. So we will get, we will find for the 1600 eggs CP. So it will be rupees 3.75 divided by 12 and multiplied it by 1600. Now we can solve. So if you remove this one will come here. After point, how many digits are there? 2. So 2, you can write 2 zeros here. Now this 2 0 2 0 cancel. Okay, 12. So 12 4 3 is 12, 4 4 is 16. Now 4 3 3 1 is 3, 3 2 is 6, 3 5 is 15. So 125 into 4. So you will get rupees 500. So what is the cost price of 1600 egg? So cost price of 1600 egg is 500. Okay. So this is the cost price. Now he sold the egg in part wise part, means in the first part he sold the first selling price of 900 eggs. First he sold the 900 eggs. Okay. So selling price of 900 eggs we have to find out. So how he sold? So there was the cost 2 eggs. In question it is given 2 eggs, selling price was rupees 1. Okay, so 2 eggs, selling price was rupees 1. So 1 eggs as selling price will be 1/2, because it will divide it. Now for the 900 egg, because in the first slot how many eggs he sold? 900 egg. So I will find the cost for the 900 egg. So for 900 eggs SP will be, so its SP will be 1/2 into 900. So we can do it here. So it is 900. So now we can solve. So here is nothing but 1. You can divide it, so it will be 450. Okay, so now what is the selling price for the 900 egg? It is your 4 rupees 440. So selling price of 900 egg was 450. Now another condition is there. Next condition is that remaining. Okay, remaining egg was sold. So first of all we will find the remaining eggs. So remaining eggs was means total egg was 1600. Total egg was 1600 and 900 already he sold. Okay, so now remaining egg was only 700. Okay, now this 700 egg he sold, this 700 egg he sold, its its rate was 5 eggs SP was 5 egg SP was rupees 2. So that was the new rate. So 1 egg SP was rupees 1/2. So now for the 700 we can find. So for the 700 egg, so SP will be, so rupees 1/2 multiplied by 700. Now you can divide it. So here I did mistake. Here 2/5 it will be, because for the 1 2/5, here will be also 2/5. Okay, now we can divide. So how many times? 5 1 time, 10 4 0. So now you can solve, you will get the selling price of 700 egg was 280. So what is the selling price of 700 egg? 280. Okay, now you can see this is the selling price of, we got the two selling price. This is for the 700 egg and 900 egg. So first of all we have to find the profit and loss. So we will get the total selling price of 1600 eggs. So what are the selling price? When we sold the first 900 eggs, so there was total, we got selling price 450, and next when we sold 700, so there we got 280. So altogether it is, what is your selling price? 730. So this is your selling price. Okay, now you can see what was your cost price. Cost price earlier we have find out, so that was only 500. So what was the cost price of the 1600 eggs? 500 only. And now what is the selling price? Now we have 733. So it means selling price is greater than cost price. So what we have? We have profit. So profit equals to SP minus CP. So SP is your, what is your SP? 730 minus 500. So when you will subtract it, you will get rupees 230. So this is the profit, 230. Now you can find the profit percent. So profit percent equals to profit divided by cost price multiplied by 100. So now profit is your 230 multiplied by 100. Cost price was 500. So now you can solve, this 00 cancel, 5 54 are 20, 546. So now what is the answer? So there is total profit was 46%. So this is the answer. So now you can see the steps how we have solved. So in this question, the one dozen bananas, eggs cost given. So we find the cost for the 1600 eggs. So there was that we got 500. Then he sold in the part wise, in the two parts. So first he sold 900 eggs. It cost was given 2x for 1 rupees. So from here we find the selling price of 900 eggs. In the remaining eggs he sold for the new cost 5 eggs. That was for rupees 2. So from here we find the selling price of 700 eggs. Now so total we have find. So to total selling price, so total we got 730. So it means the cost price was only 500. Here you can see 500, and now selling price total we have 730. It means we have the profit. So now we find the profit, and then after profit percent. Okay. Now next we can solve next question. You can see question number 7. Now next question we will solve question number 7. So here in question number 7, Rina sold two articles at rupees 840. One she gained 20%, on other she lost 20%. How much does she profit or loss in a whole transaction? Also find her profit or loss percent in the whole transaction. Means two articles she sold at the same price. Suppose same type of articles are there, okay, and she sold for the same price. What was the price? 840. But the difference, one he sold for the profit 20% and another he sold for the loss 20%. So here first of all we will find the selling in the both case selling price is given already. Selling price of first article, okay, first article, so it was rupees 840. So write 840 because it is same for the both, and there was a profit in the first one. Gain means profit, so profit was 20%. So this is the given data. Now we have to find the selling price. We have to find the cost price. So we can find the cost price here. So we can use the, so we can write if cost price is 100, then unitary by the formula also you can solve. So selling price, profit means we will add, so 100 plus 20, so it will be, what is the selling price? 120. Here you can see that selling price and cost price, we have to find the cost price. So we will change the sequence, means we will change the sentence. So because which one we have to find out, we are writing in the right side, and those are given, that we are writing in the left side. So selling price is given, so we will change it. So we can write like this: if SP is, selling price is rupees 120, then CP will be rupees 100. So for the one, if the selling price is rupees 1, so then cost price will be 100 by 120. So 100 divided by 120. So 840. So for the rupees 840, so what will be the cost price? So cost price will be equals to rupees 100 divided by 120 multiplied by 840. Now we can solve this. 00 cancel. So how many times? 7 times. So what is the cost price? Cost price for the that is 700. So this is the cost price when he sold one article for the rupees 840 and profit was 20%. Okay, this is the first case. Now for the second case, selling price of second article, same, that was rupees 840, nothing change, same, and there is a loss. There is a loss of 20%, and we have to find the first cost price. So we have to find the cost price. So same sentence we will write, same type of let CP equals to 100, then SP will be, so SP here is a loss, so it means we will minus, okay, so 100 minus 20, so it will be 80. Okay, so now here is, we have to find the cost price, and this cost price in the left side, so we will change it, we will change the sentence. So after changing the sentence, if SP equals to rupees 80, then CP cost price will be 100. Okay, so for the one, for if the selling price is rupees 1, then CP will be, cost price will be 100 by 80. Okay, now for the 840, so if the selling price is 140, then CP will be 100 by 80 into 840. Okay, now this 0 0 cancel, 2 4 is 8, 2 4 is 8, 2 2 is 4. Okay, now also here from 25 time, okay, now 25 into 42, so you will solve, you will get here, you will 1050. So when you multiply, when you will multiply 25 into 42, so you will get 1050. So this is the cost price of second article. So total selling price we can find. Okay, so total selling price of both articles, so first was 840, first we have sold for 840, and second also 840, so total selling price we have 1680. So this is the total selling price, this is the total selling price. Now we will find the total cost price of both articles. So in the first 700 we got the cost price, and the now second 1050. So altogether, what is total cost price? 1750. So you can see this is your selling price and this is your cost price. So of course here you can see the conclusion we have, since cost price is greater than selling price, so it means what is there, so it means there is a loss. So loss will be rupees 1750 minus rupees 1680. So you can subtract, so what will be the loss, so there is a loss of rupees 70 rupees loss. So we can find the loss percent. So loss percent equals to loss by cost price into 100. So now what is the loss? Loss was 70. What was the cost price? 1750 multiplied by 100. So this cancel. Now this 25 directly we can cancel it. So 25 time, this is for 4 times. So this also 7 cancel. No, this 25 for the 4 times. Yes, only 4 is remaining. So what is the loss? So there is the loss percent is 4%. So the answer, that there is a loss of 4%. Okay, so there is the loss of 4%. we can see how we have solved. First of all, selling price of first article is 840, so we find the cost price by using unitary method. Okay, so the 700, again selling price was same, but there is a loss. In this case it was profit. Okay, got it? Now next, from here we have find the cost price, so that was 1050. Now so total selling price means one was 840, so 1680 total cost price also we got. Now we can compare, we can see that cost price is greater than the selling price. You can see here, it means there is a loss. So now we find the loss percent. So likewise we can solve. Next we have question number 8. This question number 8 is same like question number 7. This question number 8 and 7, okay, same, only the difference, two computers are there. It's a, you can see here, this question number, cost price is given. Okay, so from here this is the cost price, this is the cost price, you can just write like this. This is the cost price given, okay, and there is a loss given. Again there is a cost price and there is a gain is there, 90. So you can find selling price of this one and selling price of this one, and overall you can compare. Okay, same like question number 7, same type of method you can follow. So this is the cost price of first article and loss, second cost price of second article and gain, and you can do it. Question number 9, this is same like question number 6. Okay, this question number 9 is same like question number 6. As we have solved question number 6, this one same like question number 9, because 20 shares cost is given, he sold 12 and the remaining for 20. So in two parts we have, they have sold. So first of all you can find the cost price of 20 shares, then after selling price of in two different slots, and then after you can calculate the percentage. Okay, question number 10. In question number 10, cost price is given, so this is the cost price. Okay, profit is also given, this is the 20%. And now after this, this cost price and this profit, you will find the selling price. So this selling price will be the again the cost price for this. Okay, and there is the loss. Okay, so then after you can find the overall percentage and loss. So you can do it.